Hello, my dear students. Welcome to mathematics classes for 9th standard. We are going to start today chapter number 11, that is construction. And we will learn about how to draw perpendicular, bisector, how to draw angle bisector. And we will solve our exercise 11.1. So let's start the video with your Jerry, sir.
So today we are going to start our chapter number 11, that is construction. And as you know that we don't need much concept to learn before starting the exercise. So directly we are going to start from the exercise 11.1, where first question is given this. When I will explain this question, then only I will tell you how to construct perpendicular bisector, how to construct angle bisector, and so on. Let's move to the first question of this exercise 11.1, which says that construct an angle of 90 degree at the initial point, means starting point of a given ray, and justify the construction. So let's start the solution of this question. So first I am taking a line segment. Okay, I'm giving name O. Okay, now from this O point, what I will do, I will draw any radius, any convenient radius. Okay, I'm drawing any convenient radius like this, which intersecting this line OA at point. You can give name C point. This is our C point, okay, at C point. Now, what we will do, as we have to draw 90 degree angle, or you can see we have to construct 90 degree angle like this. So remember this, when they are saying constructing, we don't need to use our D, or you can say protractor. We have to construct angle with the help of only compass. So we have drawn arc on line segment OA, which cutting at point C. Now with this C point, what we will do, we will take the same radius which through which we have drawn this arc, same radius we will take again, and we draw another arc which will cut in this way. And we can give any name to this point, like we can give D point, this one. And from the same point, again with the same radius which we have taken earlier, again we will draw another arc which will cut at point E. Okay, we can give name to them E point. Now, as you can see, this radius, this will take more than half of this radius. Let's take this much only, okay, and draw another arc upside like this. And from here draw another arc in this way. Okay, now with this point we will join point O. Okay, with the help of a scale, just take here, okay, in this way. So we got our straight line. Okay, and when you will measure it, so you will found that it is exactly how much, 90 degree angle only. How much? 90 degree. Now the thing is that we have to write steps or not, many students are asking. Yes, we have to write steps, and it is easy, very easy to write the steps. It's not too much difficult to write the steps of the construction. Okay, let me show you. Just look at here. First step. What we have done, same steps we can write, the steps of construction. It's not too much hard to write the steps. So first step is what? Step 1. We have drawn a ray OA. So we can write, draw a ray OA, as it was given that in the question that we have to draw a ray. Then second step, what we have done in second step? In second step, we have taken an arc from the center O. So what we can take with its initial, or you can say starting initial point, this O, what we have done, we have taken as a center, and you can take any radius, and any radius, what we have done, draw an arc which cutting, or you can say intersecting OA at which point? At C. Okay, so this one we have done second point. Then we can take from the C point, we have done another arc which cut at point D. Then from D we have taken another arc with the same radius which cutting at point E. And then from E and D we have taken more than half radius. Then we have taken from point D another arc which cut at this one. And then we have taken another arc from point E, which intersect each other at point P, and then we have joined this point to O. Then we got our 90 degree angle. So let's write this point. So we have written all the steps one by one. As you can see here, you can read them. At last we have joined OP, this one, O to P. So we got angle POA, or you can say angle AOP, how much? 90 degree. Now question says that justify them. So how we can justify them? Just see here. So for justification, I am going to join O to D and O to E. As you can see here, this one, dotted lines, and this one also. Okay, I am joining this ED line also. So when I join and I observe, I found that is OD and OE are working as a radius of the circle. Therefore, these two sides are equal, OD and OE. And the end, if I measure this one, ED, this is also same like OD and OE only. So I have written that OD equals to OE equals to ED. Therefore, I can say that when these all three sides are equal of this triangle, therefore, triangle OED is an equilateral triangle. Equilateral triangle, okay. And if it is equilateral triangle, so each angle will be how much? 60 degree each. Therefore, I can say angle EOD equals to how much? 60 degree. How much angle EOD? 60 degree. This one, this angle, this much only. Angle EOD, 60 degree angle. And PO is a what? Perpendicular bisector of whom? Of angle EOD. PO is what? Perpendicular bisector. Bisector of angle EOD. Okay, therefore angle, we can give any name here, D already we have, we can give name Q. So QOD, angle QOD will be half of angle EOD, okay, which means half of 60, which means it will be how much? 30 degree. So angle QOD is how much? 30 degree. Okay, now just check what we have to find out. We are finding AOP. So angle AOP equals to angle AOP made from angle AOD, or you can say angle QOD first, QOD plus angle AOD, plus angle AOD. Then it becomes what? Angle AOP. Just check here. It comes 90 or not. Angle AOP. QOD, how much comes? Just we have find out 3 degree. So we can write 30 degree here. And angle AOD, this is how much? If I join this one also, let's check here. From here to here, this line. So again, angle ODC will be also how much? It is also a equilateral triangle only. Angle ODC, see. Then also what happened? Angle DOC, or you can say angle AOD will be 60. This is all 60, this is all 60. So angle QOD 30, and angle AOD is how much? 60 degree angle. So it becomes how much? 90 degree angle. In this way, we have justified our answer. Okay, I hope it is clear. Now what they are asking, question number 2, construct an angle of 45 degree at the initial point of a given ray and justify the construction. It means it is same like question number 1, where we have done 90 degree, now we have to construct 45 degree angle. Now how we can construct 45 degree? It is also very easy. As we have construct 90 degree angle, so same again what we will do, we will construct 90 degree angle. Okay, so I will not repeat how we will construct, you know how I constructed. So in the same way, as I have taken angle AOP, how much? 90 degree I have constructed already. Now after constructing this, what I have to do? I have to make an angle bisector of this angle. But this is already 90. If I will do angle bisector, so what is the work of angle bisector? Angle bisector divide the angle into two equal parts. So what is the half of 90? That is will be what? 45 degree angle. So let's let's construct angle bisector. So take any convenient radius. You can take any convenient radius. Okay. And with that, I will take an arc which intersecting the given this OA at X and OP at Y. Okay. And then I will take this XY. Okay. This is radius XY. This is a radius XY. Now I will take more than half. So it is half is maybe it will come here. It is more than half, and then I will draw an arc from point X and then from point Y also, which will cut in this way. And I will join this point to this. So with the help of scale, I have drawn a construction. So X, Y, I can give name Z here. So ZO is the angle construction, you can say, perpendicular angle bisector of POA. Now angle ZOA will be half of angle AOP. So angle half of 90 degree, how much? 45 degree. Therefore angle ZOA is how much? 9 degree angle, 45 degree angle. This is 45, this much only. How much? 45 degree angle. Okay, this one, this full is 90, and this ZOA is how much? 45 degree angle. So what we have done, just 90 we have constructed as already we have constructed. So again we construct like that only, and then we construct angle bisector. What we construct? Angle bisector of angle POA. So we got angle ZOA 45 degree. Okay, now steps and justification you will do as we have done in question number 1. Now in question number 3, they are saying construct the angles of the following measurements. First one is 30 degree angle. So first I have drawn OA ray, okay, of OP ray of any centimeter. Now what I am doing, I will draw a arc from the initial point O. This is the initial point, starting point O. I will draw an arc of any convenient radius, okay, not too much more, not too much less. Any convenient radius, I will construct and take an arc. I have taken an arc which intersecting the given line, the given ray at point Q. At which point? At Q. Okay. Now what I am doing, just check. From the same radius which I have taken earlier, I will draw another arc from the point Q. Now my center point is what? Q. So from center point Q, I am drawing another arc which intersecting the given arc at point R. Okay. Now, as we know that when we're constructing with the same radius, the given arc, so it makes how much angle? 60 degree angle. So this angle, if I join this line from here to here, like this, if I'm drawing, just check here, if I'm going to draw like this line, so how much it will be? It will be ROP will be how much? 60 degree angle. But here we need to draw what? 30 degree angle. So angle ROP we got how much? 60 degree. Okay, but we have to draw 30 degree angle. So we know very well angle bisector. If I draw the angle bisector of this angle ROP, so I will get 30 degree. So what I do? I will do what? I will take QR as a radius more than half. Okay, not take full radius, but more than half radius I will take, and I will draw an arc from first from Q point and then from R point. Okay, I have drawn two arcs which intersecting at some point, and we will join this point of intersection with the point O. Okay, in this way, and I can give any name S. Okay, so this SOP will be what? Half of angle 60 degree angle. Why? Because SO is the angle bisector. SO is the angle bisector of angle ROP. Okay, SO, or you can say OS. So how much? Half 1 upon 2 into 60, it means 230. How much comes? Angle SOP, or you can say POS, how much comes? 30 degree angle. So in this way we have drawn this one 30 degree. I hope it is clear to you. Now in second part, we have to draw, or we can say we have to construct the angle of 22.5 degree, or we can say 22 and half. Half means 0.5 only. So I have written 22.5. Okay. Now how we can draw? When it's half angle is coming, which we have not seen earlier, so multiply by 2. 22.5. If you multiply by 2, so what will come? It will come to 10, 0, 1, 2 to the 4, 5, 2 to the 4. It comes 45.0. It means it comes 45 degree angle. How much? 45. It means it is the half of 45 degree angle. So how we are drawing 45 degree angle? Just we have seen question number 2, by making the angle bisector of 9 degree angle. So we have taken angle AOP, how much? 90 degree angle. Now we can draw what? Angle bisector of this angle in this way. I have taken arc, then from this arc I will cut one bisector here, one arc here, and from this point I will take another. Okay, let's make little longer, and this way I have drawn 45 degree angle. What? 45 degree angle. Okay, angle R POR, we can say angle POR is how much, angle ROP also you can say 45 degree angle. Okay, this one 45 degree angle, but we don't need to draw 45 degree angle, we have to draw 22.5. so it means I have to draw the angle bisector of angle ROP also. So I can take this one name as a B and this point as a C. I will take more than half radius of this arc and draw two arcs more in this way. Okay, and taking this arc also, and where they both intersect each other, that point will be only my what, 22.5 degree angle, like this. So this point, okay, I can give name also, can give name S. So here angle we can say angle POS is what, half of angle ROP, and half of ROP means half of 45 degree angle. So it will come 2.5, it means 22.5, or we can say 22.5, that is only angle POS. So in this way we can draw or construct angle POS. So this is, this part is how much, 22.5 degree, or we can 22.5 degree angle. Okay, now next angle is given 15 degree. So what you will do, 15 to your 30, 30 is the half of 60. It means first you have to construct 60 degree angle, or you can draw 60 degree angle with the help of protractor. Then you have to do the angle bisector of 60, which is 30. And then again you have to do the angle bisector of 30, which is 15 degree. So in this way you can, same as we have done this part, in the same way you will do third part also. Now move to question number 4. Construct the following angles and verify by measuring them by protractors. First, it means first you have to draw or construct with the help of compass, and then you have to take the help of protractor and then check whether you have made correct or not. So first part is what, 75 degree. So let's make this one. So in order to construct 75 degree angle, first I have taken OY line of any radius, and then taking O as center, I am drawing an arc, okay, which intersecting OY at point A. Okay, at point A. Now A as center, with the same radius I am drawing another arc which intersecting the previous arc at point B. Okay, and from the B point with the same radius, another I am taking one more arc which intersecting at point D. Okay, now as you can see, if I join this line, so it will come how much, 60 degree angle, but I don't need 60, I need 75. How much more than 75 from 60? We can say 60 plus 15 degree, it will come how much, 75 degree. So 60 degree we have drawn. If I join OB, so it becomes 60 degree angle only, but I need 75, so I have to take on more construction. So first I will draw 9 degree angle here, or we can say we construct 9 degree angle here. How? I have taken BD radius more than half. Okay, more than half you can take like this and draw arc in this way and join this line. So what I will get, I will get, okay, here I will get what, 9 degree angle from point this one, 9 degree angle. Angle can give name E, EOY. Angle EOY is how much, 90 degree angle, but we don't need this 90 degree angle. What we need here, 60 plus 60, 120, but we have done half of this one. So how much this part, if I join this part from the pencil O to B, dotted lines, okay, so how much this part, we can give name to this point also, F. So how much FOB, this is how much, 60 half FOB, because this is the perpendicular bisector, no? So it is how much FOB, this is 30 degree angle. So 60 plus 30, it is 90. If I draw half of this FOB, see, angle FOB, angle FOB is how much, it is 30 degree angle. Why? Because we have done half of 60, That's why 30 comes. So it is 30 degree angle. If I do half of this angle also, so how much it becomes? It becomes 30 degree angle. 15 degree. Okay. So let's draw half of this angle. Radius more than half of FB we have taken, and we have drawn arc like this from B point and then from F point in this way, which cut at point X, and we have drawn a line. This blue line I have drawn. So it become angle XOA, angle XOY, or you can say angle XOA, or you can say XOY, same thing. So XOY, how much? This is 75. Why? Because now this is half of 60, it means this is half of 30, this is 15 degree. Angle XOB. Angle XOB is how much? 15 degree. Okay. We can say XOB. So XOY is made from angle XOB plus angle AOB, where angle XOB is how much? 15 degree, and AOB 60. So it becomes how much? 75 degree automatically. So in this way we can justify also, but we don't need to justify here, just I have explained you. So now we are doing question number 4, second part, where we have to construct angle 105 degree. So for 105 we know that if we add 90 plus 15, see, you will subtract 105 minus 90, so how much will come? Because 105 is most near to 90 in compared to 60, so when you subtract, what will come? 15 degree. So it means if we add 90 plus 15, so what will become? 105. So we can use this concept here. So with the help of scale, I have drawn one line PQ, and on PQ first I have to construct 90 degree angle. So for that, first I have to make some arc. I have taken a convenient radius, not too much more, not too much less, okay, and with that radius I am taking arc like this, which intersecting line PQ at some points. Okay, we can give any name to them. We can give name like A, okay, this point, and from this point I can take another arc. This is, you know that this arc, if I draw like this line, so it will make how much? 60 degree angle. Now I will draw one more arc with the same radius. So how much? This much second arc. The second arc, if I will join this line, so it will make how much? 120 from here to here, 120 degree angle. Okay, now I have to construct how much? 9 degree angle. So from this same point only I will draw another arc upside, then from this point another arc here, okay, and I will join this line, so I will get 9 degree angle. In this way I got 9 degree angle. Okay, little bit mistake is there, but you can draw properly. Okay, so I can give name also. We have drawn this angle, 9 degree angle, angle RPQ. This point is what? R point. Okay, so angle RPQ, as you can see, at first we have drawn ray PQ, we have drawn ray PQ, at which, at point P, from initial point we have drawn angle RPQ. How much? RPQ is how much? 9 degree angle. Now using second arc, this arc, I am using the second arc. If I join this line, as I told you earlier also, so how much, which angle they will make? They will make 120 degree angle. From here to here, how much? 120 degree angle. Okay, so using the second arc, I am drawing again another angle at point P, which is SPQ. Okay, so I can give name also. In this line I can give name SPQ. SPQ. SPQ, this full angle. How much? 120 degree. Now if I have to bisect this angle RP, I just check RPS. See, RPQ is how much? 90. So how much left? This much to becomes 120, 30 na. So it means this angle from here to here, it is how much? 30 degree angle. How much? 30 degree angle. But as I told you, in order to make 105, what I need to do? I have to add 15 in 90. So it is already 90. Angle RPQ is already how much? 90. I have to add 15, but this is 30. So let's do what? Bisect this angle. Which angle? Angle RPS, or you can say SPR, anything you can say. So let's, using second arc, I have used S, and I'm going to bisect angle RPS. Let's bisect this angle. First I'm going to rub this 30 from here, it will confuse you otherwise. Okay, so by using this radius, more than half. I am going to draw arc from here and from one arc from this side, and where these both will intersect with the help of blue pen, I am joining this line. So this angle I can give name T. What name I'm giving? T. So TPQ, angle TPQ is our required angle, because this is how much? 90 from here to here, 90, and this is how much? 15. So 90 plus 15, it becomes how much total full from here to here? It becomes 105 degree angle. So we can say angle TPQ is how much? 105 degree angle, where TPR is 15 and RPQ 90. TPR 15 and RPQ 90. If we add both of them, so it comes 105 degree angle. So in this way, we have considered second part of question number 4, where you have to construct angle 105 degree. So I hope now you can draw the third part also, 135 degree. As 135 is there, so 120 plus how much? 15. So first we will draw 120 degree angle, we will construct, and then we will add 15 degree in that much. So we will get our 135 degree angle. So now move to question number 5. Construct an equilateral triangle given its side and justify the construction. So let's do this question. So as we have to construct equilateral triangle, so I have drawn a line segment AB of 5 cm. Okay, now what I have to do, I will draw an arc with the help of compass or some radius, taking A as our center, okay, which is intersecting AB at some point, as you can see here, and I will give this point name as P. Okay, I can write with the pen also. I'm giving this name P. Okay, now taking P as center, same radius, just check. Yes, same radius. Now taking P as center, I am doing what? I am drawing an arc to intersect the previous arc at point E. This one, this arc, the same arc, the bigger arc. Now taking P as center, I am drawing another arc which intersecting the previous arc at point E. This point I will give name E. Okay, this E. Now I will join this A to E. A to E. Okay, and I will extend this line to upside. Okay, this one AE. So I am just following the steps, join AE. We have joined AE. Now taking A as center, taking A this as center, as I have drawn AB 5 cm. So I am making what? An equilateral triangle. So I will take 5 cm again. Radius here, 5 cm, just check. Yes, 5 cm. So taking 5 cm radius and A as center, I will cut an arc of 5 cm, which will cut this extended line AE, at some point. And I will give that point name as point C. Okay, and now what I will do, I will join this B to C. So I can join this one, B line to C line. Okay, in this way. So as I told you, first I have drawn this arc to make how much angle? 60 degree angle. So what is given to us? We have ABC angle we have made 5 cm. This is also how much? 5 cm we have drawn. Now what I am saying, we got our equilateral triangle where all angles should be how much? 5 cm. All sides should be 5 cm and all angles are how much? 60 degree angle. Now we need to justify this. How? So let's justify it. Justify. How we can justify? See, in triangle ABC which we have drawn, in triangle ABC, here AB is equals to AC. AB is equals to AC. As you can see, 5 cm. Okay, so why we can write 5 cm. And angle A also given how much? We have drawn 60 degree angle. Okay, one angle is given. Now we can see as AB is equals to AC. So AB is equals to AC, so angle opposite to that equal sides are also equal. So we can say angle B is equals to angle C. Why? Angles opposite to equal sides. Okay, clear? Angle B equal to angle C. Now just check in triangle ABC. In triangle ABC, angle sum property, angle A plus angle B plus angle C equals to how much? 180. Okay, where angle A already given how much? 60. So we can write 60. Angle B, now in place of angle C, what I am writing? This one. I am using this one. Just I said angle B equals to angle C. So in place of angle C, I am writing angle B only. equals to 180. So 60 plus twice of angle B equals to 180. So twice of angle B equals to 180 minus 60. So it comes angle B equals to 180 minus 120, 60, it comes 120. And this 2 will come downside. So 260 is a 120. So it comes how much? Angle B comes how much? Angle B is equals to what? Angle C. And which is equals to how much? 60 degree. Therefore, angle B equals to angle C, how much? 60. And angle A is already how much? 60. So angle A equals to angle B equals to angle C equals 60 degree angle. So I have proved that all angles are how much? 60 degree angle. This is our equation first, I can say. Okay. And AB is how much? 5. Okay. This, I am saying angle A equals to angle B. This already equals to 5 centimeter. Now I have to prove that this BC is also how much? 5 centimeter. So in order to prove this, that in order to prove that this BC is 5 centimeter, I can say angle A equals to angle B. Just beside C, angle A equals to angle B. So sides opposite to equal angles are also equal. So we can say BC equals to AC. Okay, so this BC will be also why they are equal? Sides opposite to equal angles are also equal. Therefore, this side is also how much? 5 centimeter. Now, all sides are how much? 5, 5, 5. And all angles are how much? 60, 60. Therefore, we can say that, yes, triangle ABC is a required equilateral triangle. So, in this way, we have justified also. I hope it is clear to you now. So, we have completed our exercise 11.1.
At last, I just want to say, be safe and God bless you all.